Hey guys, it's Gronz, the FlyHere660 channel. I haven't done an update video in a while, so I figured I'd just do one today. And so how was everyone's Thanksgiving? Hope you guys all had a great Thanksgiving. I know I sure did. I went up to New York. Me and my parents, we stayed at my girlfriend's place with her family and everything. It was really nice, you know, whole family thing, eating a lot of food, hanging out. It's pretty fun. Cold. It was also really cold. And I had a really great trip. Me and my mom flew from Miami to Orlando, and then from Orlando to Kennedy. And anytime I go flying, no matter where I am, I always like talking to pilots and whatnot. It's just something that I just like to do, and I like to sometimes keep in contact with them. There's a lot of pilots I keep in contact, and I'm always asking for their emails and whatnot. And I'm not going to say the names of any of the pilots because, you know, I think I'd rather just keep that on the down low or whatever. But on the way up there, we flew on the 737-700 next generation, and the pilot, I saw the captain for our flight, and I was asking him, you know, about some good, like, some tips for becoming a pilot, like how to get into the industry, what's good and whatnot, what should I avoid, all that stuff. And, you know, he asked me, hey, you know, like, why don't you just come in the cockpit, whatnot. Really funny guy. He's also really tall. He's like, I think he's like almost 7 feet tall. You really big guy. And yeah, so he took me to the cockpit. We were he let me sit in the co-pilot seat with him, and he was just showing me all the panel of the plane and whatnot, explaining everything. And he kind of like gave me a quiz. He was asking me like, so what does this do, what does that do? And you know, I had most of my stuff down pretty well. And he was a really great guy, and I've been keeping in contact with him and whatnot. And he went through the Navy. That's how he did his flying. And he said, like, you know, the military is one way to go, but now how things are now, you know, it doesn't even matter anymore. I also met a pilot actually before that flight here in Miami. He was actually on the plane with us, but he was only going back home to Orlando. He flies in California for what's it called? I'm trying to remember the name of the company he flies for. I know they fly the Brasilia. I don't remember the name. Oh, SkyWest? No, I don't know if it was SkyWest. I'm not sure, but it's like a commuter plane. And he was a co-pilot for this commuter company and everything. And he knows a guy who works in the FAA, and he gave me his contacts and whatnot, so I could get help with schools and anything like that. Helping, you know, it's good. Like, I think it's really good if you, like, when you go flying and whatnot, like, if you want to be a pilot and everything, you want to get into that kind of business and everything, it's really good to keep, like, get connections with people. That's the one thing that a lot of pilots have told me and want to try and get connected, try and get in contact with as many people that you know that's, like, in the business and whatnot, and they can help you along the way. You never know. Like, some of the pilots I was talking to were even saying, hey, if you need me for, like, a recommendation or something, just send me an email or whatever, and I'll gladly help you. And also, I'm like, I want to be like their friends too. Like, they're really cool guys and everything. Like, I mean, most of the pilots I've met. And on the way back, I flew back by myself because my parents left on Friday, and I left on Sunday. And I flew from, I had to do the same thing, except this time I was on the 757. The first 757 was the 200, which was it was an older one. It had the older glass cockpit, and then I flew from JFK to Miami, and then from there I flew from Orlando to Miami. And when we were in Orlando, I was talking with the captain of the 757 flight, and there was also two American Eagle pilots that were at the counter with the captain, and I was asking them the same questions, like, you know, about, like, schools and all kinds of things like that. And I got all their names and everything, and, you know, we were just chit-chatting about flying. And I always fly standby since, you know, my dad works for American Airlines, so I'm always, like, a non-rev. And I was waiting to get my ticket, and before the captain went on the plane, he says, "Oh, you know, when you get on the plane, come to the cockpit and everything, and we'll just have you sit down and everything." I was like, "All right, cool." So I get my ticket, and it says group 6, and they're still calling like group 2, and it's taking forever. And then all of a sudden, I see the captain come back out, and he's like, "Hey," he's like, "get over here." And I'm like, "All right, sure," you know. I'm like, "What's up?" And I'm like, and he goes, "Hey, listen, you know, you're never going to be able to sit in the cockpit and everything with all these people in front of you, so I'm just going to, like, just follow me." So basically, we just cut the whole line, and then when we got to the end of the line, when we got in the plane, he held the line so I could put my stuff down, put it in the overhead compartment, all of the stuff, and then he took me to the cockpit. We get in the cockpit, and he whips out the jump seat, and he just says, "All right, so just sit down and just, you know, like, just relax." And I sat in the I didn't sit in the jump seat for the flight, I wish. But I sat in the jump seat as they were doing their, I guess, before departure checklist. And they did their checklists, one of the checklists. And I was talking to the co-pilot and the captain. Both of those guys were hilarious. They were really cool guys. I'm also been keeping in contact with them ever since I met them and everything. And he's going to be retiring soon. He's been flying for American for, I think, at least 24 years now, so it's a pretty long time. And, the plane was really full, so I got to, and we also got delayed, and I was like, "Oh, I'm going to go back to my seat now." And he goes, "Oh, well, why?" He goes, "Don't go back yet, you know, we're still loading the plane, and it looks like we're going to be delayed about 20 minutes." So I basically spent, like, around 20 minutes in the jump seat with them, and they didn't mind at all. I was like, "All right, sure, why not?" And, you know, when we were sitting there, I was like, "Oh, can I take a picture?" And he goes, "Yeah, sure." And then he goes, "You know, how about we take this a picture like this?" And he goes, "You know, you could sit in my seat." So I got to sit in the captain's seat, and he put his hat on my head, and he took a picture, and I felt like a little kid. Like, I was, like, so happy and everything. Like, it was really cool. But yeah, so that was basically all that happened for my Thanksgiving. It was really fun. And right now I'm getting ready for finals week, which is the week after next week, the week coming up. And I just finished registering for my second term. And for my second term, let's see if I have it here. I chose, since I'm doing flying, like, you know, at Teterboro. Since I'm doing flying at, what's the freaking name of the airport? Tamiama. I figured, you know, I should do my backup major at the school. So I decided to take computer engineering technology. And, you know, I've been into computers for a long time, just as much as flying. So I'm going to do that as my backup. And that's about it. So, yeah. So how about you guys? How was your Thanksgiving? Anything crazy happen? Do you guys have any stories to share about traveling, like meeting pilots or anything like that? And, you know, let me know. And also, like I said before, it's always, don't be afraid to ask questions to, like, you know, anyone that's in the aviation business or whatever. It's always good to talk to pilots. It's always good to get, like, that connection, that whole, like, networking thing, they would call it. It's always good to do that. And, alright, so that's it. I'm going to be posting up a video pretty soon, so I hope you guys enjoy that next video, and I'll talk to you guys later. Alright, bye.